kindly join in singing, Loving Father. Loving Father. Loving Father, God so faithful and true. Loving Father, God so faithful and true. We praise you, adore you, we bow down before you. Loving Father, God so faithful and true. Thanksgiving Masses offered by Sean George on his birthday for the intentions of Pope Francis, Vitilia, Damasiano, Traciano, Margaret, and Richard Fernandez. Mons Mine Masses for Donald Fossey and Sabina. Death anniversary of Videncia D'Souza. For the souls of Camilo Marias, Angeline and Baptiste D'Souza, Carl Alfonso, Carmina Pereira, Father Joseph Katikaran, Caetano Rosario Pinto, Lalita Mani, David D'Souza, Joachim Samuel Carvalho, and departed members of the family, Joe Dias, Andrea Ribeiro D'Souza, Mrs. C. L. Deshpande, Ephrogene and Joseph D'Souza, Abraham Kalakrakal, Etty Raj, and departed members of the family, Buselli Thomas, Louis Rodericks, Carmen Dante, Anthony De Silva, Maruti Jadhav, and Lino Pimenta. For the departed members of Mada Palimatham family and for the souls in purgatory.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear sisters and dear brothers, as we thank God for the privilege of participating in this Eucharist, let us prepare our hearts and minds by acknowledging our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord drew the sea back by a strong east wind all night, and made the sea dry land, and the waters were divided. And the Lord of Israel went into the midst of the sea on dry ground, the waters being a wall to them on their right and on their left. The Egyptians pursued and went in after them into the midst of the sea. All Pharaoh's horses, his chariots, and his horsemen. And in the morning watch, the Lord in the pillar of fire and of cloud looked down on the Egyptian forces, and they threw the Egyptian forces into the sea, clogging their chariot wheels, so they drove heavily. And the Egyptians said, "Let us flee from before Israel, for the Lord fights for them against the Egyptians." The Lord said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, that the water may come back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots, and upon their horsemen." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the sea returned to its normal course when the morning appeared. And as the Egyptians fled into it, the Lord threw the Egyptians into the midst of the sea. The waters returned and covered the chariots and the horsemen of all the host of Pharaoh that had followed them into the sea. Not one of them remained. But the people of Israel walked on dry ground through the sea, the waters being a wall to them on their right hand and on their left. Thus the Lord saved the day from the hand of the Egyptians. And Israel saw the Egyptians dead on the seashore. Israel saw the great power that the Lord used against the Egyptians. So the people feared the Lord, and they believed in the Lord and his servant Moses. Then Moses and the people of Israel sang this song to the Lord, saying, "I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider he has thrown into the sea." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response shall be, "I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously."
I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously.
At the blast of your nostrils, the waters piled up. The floods stood upon in a pile. The deeps congealed in the heart of the sea. The enemy said, "I will pursue, I will overtake. I will divide the spoil. My desire shall have its fill of them. I will draw my sword, my hands shall destroy them."
I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously.
You blew your wind, the sea covered them. They sank like lead in the mighty waters. You stretched out your right hand, the earth swallowed them.
I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously.
You'll bring them in and plant them on your own mountain, the place, O Lord, you have made for your own abode, the sanctuary, O Lord, which your hands have established.
I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. As we open our hearts to Jesus joyfully. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
If anyone loves me, he'll keep my word, says the Lord, and my Father will love him and will come to him.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
At that time, while Jesus was speaking to the people, behold, his mother and his brothers stood outside, asking to speak to him. But he replied to the man who told him, "Who is my mother and who are my brothers?" And stretching out his hand towards his disciples, he said, "Here are my mother and my brothers. For whoever does the will of my Father in heaven is my brother and sister and mother." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear sisters and dear brothers in Jesus Christ, all of us in life go through difficulties at different phases of our life. Sickness, pain, failures, confusion, chaos. Sometimes, with all these things, life seems overwhelming. Sometimes it becomes difficult and we don't see the road ahead. If we have been through situation of this kind, or if we are going through this phase, this moment, at this moment in our lives, the readings today offer us hope. In the first reading, these days we have been hearing about the journey of the Israelites. And now that Pharaoh has given them leave to go to their land, he also realizes that he has made a mistake by letting the slaves go. And as Israelites journey, they see behind them Pharaoh's army and before them the Red Sea. Literally, they are between the devil and the deep sea. And in this situation, what do? They cry out to God, and the Lord tells them through Moses, "The Lord will fight for you. You have only to be still. The Lord will fight for you." Yes, they believed that the Lord would fight for them. And as God had promised in today's reading, we heard God leading them in a very spectacular way through the Red Sea. In fact, this is one of the oft-quoted incident in the Old Testament. Amazing deliverance by God. And they remembered it. How was it possible? It was possible because they obeyed the voice of God. They did the will of God. Obedience to the will of God brought deliverance. It brought liberation. And in the Gospel, Jesus continues the same theme, and he tells that you have to follow the will of God. You have to obey the voice of God. Mary is honored not just because she is the mother of Jesus, but because she is the first disciple and the best disciple of Jesus. She obeyed the will of God. And dear sisters and dear brothers, we too can be the members of family, not just because of our baptism, but more so by the love that we have for one another, as he often tells us, but more so also because we are called to do his will. In fact, in our lives, we have our own dreams. Even our wildest dreams can turn into incredible reality when we offer it into the hands of God. Today, dear sisters and brothers, no matter what we are going through, let us surrender everything into the hands of God. Maybe some of us feel that we too are literally between the devil and the deep sea at this moment. Let us know for sure that the Lord will fight for us. Let us be still. Let us be silent in his presence. Amen.
There are numerous strings in your lute. Let me add my own among them. Then when you smite your chords, my heart will break its silence and and my life will be one with your song. There are numerous strings in your lute. Let me add my own among them.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift, since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, earth is full of your glory. Glory fills the heavens too. Sing to him, Hosanna. Blessed is the one who comes, bringing this great glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, sing to him, Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Oswald our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Each time we pray the prayer, Our Father, we tell God, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Difficult though as it is, let us ask Him for the grace and the courage to do His will in all that we do. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Prayer in times of coronavirus. Mother of perpetual help, with the greatest confidence, we come before your picture to beseech your intercession. We think of you, Mother, at the foot of the cross. Your heart must have bled to see your son in agony. But your joy was great when he rose from the dead, victorious over the powers of evil. Mother of sorrows, pray for us in this time of trial. Help us not to lose heart. intercede for your people who are afflicted with coronavirus. Comfort your people who are vulnerable and anxious. Protect healthcare workers who put their lives at risk. Inspire our leaders to make good decisions. Change our hearts so that we may act responsibly. Teach us to trust in God's love and mercy and to share with you the joy of having courageously faced up to all the challenges of life. Amen. Mother of perpetual help,
pray for us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Kindly join in singing, What Thanks, O Lord. What thanks? What thanks, O Lord, can I render thee for all the gifts thou hast showered on me? Each day I'll sing of your praise and glory. Hallelujah.